The Microsoft Surface Pro versus the Microsoft Surface Go. Which one should you buy? Let's find out. Let's first start with the price, because I think that's one of the biggest differences between these two devices. A Surface Pro 9 new is around 1000 euros, whereas a Surface Go 3 brand new is around 400 euros. Both of them don't include the type cover. For the Surface Go, that's around 100 euros extra, and for the Pro, it's around 130 to 180 euros extra. The models that I have are a little bit older, so I have the Surface Pro 7 instead of the 9 and the first generation Surface Go instead of the Go 3, but they are still pretty similar. So for the specs, both of them have different configurations. You can get the Pro model in an i3, i5, i7 configuration, and the newer models only have an i5 or i7, whereas the Surface Go has an Intel Pentium or an i3 processor. And this can be paired with 4 or 8 gigabytes of RAM, but the Surface Pro can go all the way up to 32 gigabytes of RAM. The Surface Go has 64 or 128 gigabytes of storage, and the newer Surface Pros can go all the way up to 32 gigabytes of RAM and with 1 terabyte SSD, but that will cost you a lot of money. It will go all the way up to 2680 euros. The build quality of both devices are really amazing. They both have magnesium on the back, and on the front they have a nice touchscreen. And also the keyboard on both models feel really good and they type really well. Of course on the Surface Go it is a little bit smaller because the form factor is also smaller. But both of them type really well and I really like the keys. And the trackpad is also really good on both of them. I don't think it is the best trackpad ever, but it's definitely a really good one. Both of the keyboards do have a little bit of flex to them. And also you can adjust both of them, so you can move it down or move it up. And of course you can remove the keyboard on both models. But as you can see, there is a bit of a difference in size. So the Pro keyboard will not work on the Go, and the Go keyboard will not work on the Pro, because the connectors are different. So if I try to connect it, it doesn't work, and it also looks really weird. And that's the same for the Pro keyboard on the Go. Both of them have different ports and buttons. Both of them have the Surface Connect port, so you can charge it magnetically or you can connect a dock to it. And the newer Surface Pro have two USB-C ports instead of one USB-C and one USB-A port, like on my model. The Surface Pro 9 does not have a headphone jack, but the Surface Go 3 does have one, and I think that's one really important factor. And if you quickly want to plug in headphones, it's not possible on the Pro, so you need to buy a dongle. On the Pro 8 and earlier, they do have a headphone jack, so that's also something you want to consider. Maybe buy the older Pro 8 or Pro 7 instead of the latest model. Most of the newer Surface Pros have the Intel Iris graphics, and the Surface Go has the Intel UHD graphics, so the graphics performance is definitely worse on the Surface Go models. But that doesn't mean it's terrible, but it's also not good, so you don't want to use it for gaming. And the Surface Go is really meant for things like internet browsing, making a Teams call, using Office like PowerPoint or Word, but it's not really something you want to use for gaming or video editing. However, if you buy a new Surface Pro with a pretty good configuration, you can do some video editing and gaming on it. Don't expect the best performance, it's not a gaming machine and it's not meant to play games. But you can definitely do some light or medium gaming on the Surface Pro, but don't expect to run the AAA games on a really high frame rate, because it doesn't have a dedicated graphics card, but it does have the better Intel Iris Xe graphics. The displays of both of these machines are really nice and I really like them. And the brightness of both screens are bright enough for indoors. However, outdoors when it's a really sunny day, it isn't bright enough, but for indoors use it's really good. The Surface Pro has a larger screen compared to the Go, and at first I thought it's only 2 or 3 inches and it doesn't really matter. But after using it, I definitely prefer to use the Pro when I'm using it as a laptop, because that little bit of extra screen size makes it a lot easier to see things. And the Go is a little bit tiny, and especially if you have trouble reading small text. So if you have problem reading small text, the Surface Pro is definitely a better option. But both displays have touchscreens and they look really nice. And they also both support the Surface Pen. If you want to draw something, they both work amazing. And I don't have any complaints about the display. The battery life, in my experience, has been better on the Surface Go than the Pro. However, I bought both of mine used, and the Go was in really good condition and the Pro wasn't, so that probably makes a difference, so I can't really tell you which one is better. So my tests aren't really accurate, and according to Microsoft, the Surface Go has a worse battery life than the Surface Pro. But if you buy one brand new, then the Pro will be better. But from my experience, the Go is better because it's been used a lot less. And the Surface Go only has a single USB-C port. And on the top you can see both of them have the power button and volume buttons. And under the kickstand they have also a micro SD card slot. Also, the Surface Pro 9 doesn't have a SD card slot, so if you want to plug in an SD card for extra storage, it isn't possible, and that's really annoying. However, it's still here on the Surface Pro 7. Also, because of the smaller size on the Surface Go, it just feels more naturally and more easy to use as a tablet. I feel like the Pro is a little bit too big as a tablet, but the Go is a little bit too small for a laptop. But that doesn't mean that the Pro is extremely big, but it just feels a little bit on the bigger side. Both of them do get a little bit warm when you use them a lot. Some of the Pro models have a fan inside for better performance, but the Pro that I have doesn't have one, and it doesn't really overheat that much. It's just a little bit warm on the back. The Surface Go has a 1920 by 1280 aspect ratio, and it's 3x2 on both models, and the Pro has a 2880 by 1920 display resolution. But both of them look really good. The Go 3 has a Gorilla Glass 3 and the Pro 9 has Gorilla Glass 5. So that means that the Pro 9 has a better durability for the screen. Both of them have really good cameras for a laptop. They aren't amazing, but more than good enough for making a Teams call. Or if you want to take something that's ahead of you, there's also a camera on the back, which is nice. They both have front-facing speakers, and they aren't amazing, but they are good enough. For unlocking methods, both have a Windows Hello facial recognition camera, so if you quickly want to log in, both of them work really well, and it also works really fast. And for the Pro model, there is an optional keyboard with a fingerprint sensor in it, and it isn't available for the Surface Go. Also, both of them have really nice hinges, and they stay at where you leave it, and you can quickly adjust them, and they stay in place. They feel really nice and you can put them really high or really low. However, if you want an angle like this, it isn't possible on both models. But it's also really nice when you use it as a tablet. You can quickly set it down and watch a movie or something. And here you can see the size difference. It may not look like much, but you can definitely carry this one easier around. It's just so light and so small and easy to carry. Whereas this one is also a bit heavier, so it feels a little bit big as you use it as a normal tablet because of the weight and the size. And they both have options for different type cover colors. And the Surface Go is available in silver and black. Whereas the newer Surface Pro 9 is available in silver, black, green or blue. So last up, let's talk about the performance. Like I said, both of them have different configurations available. So the newer versions of the Pro have an i5 or i7. Whereas the Go has a Pentium or an i3. And you can definitely notice a difference between them. I think the Pro overall just feels a bit faster when doing multiple tabs open and having a lot running in the background. So if you want to open Google Chrome, Teams, Microsoft Word and PowerPoint all at the same time, then the Surface Pro overall feels a lot faster. And it's definitely something I notice. And also, if you want to use the devices for a longer period of time, I feel like the Surface Pro can last a lot longer than the Surface Go because of its performance. And also for gaming, the Surface Go isn't really meant for it, and the Surface Pro isn't meant for it too, but it can still run some light gaming. And if you're going to do video editing without shooting in 8K or a lot of video effects, the Surface Pro will handle it fine, but the Surface Go isn't really meant for it. And also, editing videos on the screen this small can be really annoying. That doesn't mean that it isn't impossible. If you need to edit a really basic video, it can work fine on the Surface Go. But if you want to do more effects and multiple layers, the Surface Pro will handle that a lot better. And that's also with export time. So if you are exporting your video, the Surface Pro will finish much faster exporting the video than the Surface Go. So if you want something that is small, light, easy to carry, and can do the basic things like watching YouTube videos and typing some Word documents, I think that the Surface Go is a really good option. And you definitely don't need the Pro for that, because the Go will work fine for that. However, if you want a bigger screen size and also better performance, so some video editing or some light gaming, then the Surface Pro is definitely the one you want to get. And even when doing some basic things like internet browsing, the Surface Pro definitely feels a bit faster. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and thank you for watching.